Well, there's another great mystery when it comes to the languages of our past. Scientists know this, linguists know this very well. Every language, every single alphabet that has ever been known to exist, bar none, cuneiform, Arabic, Hebrew, Sanskrit, every Greek, every alphabet that's ever been created, has always had a mysterious number linked to the letter that it represents. No one knows for sure where those numbers came from. The numbers never change. They are a constant. So the numbers that are linked to the letters of ancient alphabets, they allow us to think of those alphabets mathematically. So here's what I did as a scientist. I compared the ancient text 3,000 years old and the elements that it describes that make us with the elements of the periodic table. The ancient elements of hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, and carbon, we find in the periodic table as the letters, and they have numbers associated with them. And the numbers that I linked from those ancient alphabets, as I looked at the atomic mass and the atomic weight of our elements, lo and behold, they are the same. They overlap. The atomic mass of hydrogen links precisely with very specific letters in ancient Hebrew, Arabic, and Sanskrit. The atomic mass for oxygen links precisely with letters in those ancient alphabets. So here's what I did. I replaced the letters in the ancient text with the elements of the periodic table. And when I did that and applied it to DNA, because DNA is made of hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, and carbon in different combinations. When I took the ancient alphabets and I replaced the elements of the DNA with those alphabets, the DNA began to read as you read letters in a sentence in the page upon a book. Our DNA holds a message that can only be read by crossing the traditional boundaries of science and spirituality. And it helps us one more piece with this clue of our origin. Because the very first sentence, the very first line of every strand of every human DNA says exactly the same thing. And here's what it says. When we replace those letters with a periodic table and we begin reading the text, the very first sentence in every strand of DNA literally says the words, God eternal within the body. God eternal within the body. It doesn't say who God is, how that got there, or why it's there. I'm just sharing with you what happens when we marry science and spirituality. So that gives us one more insight. Now that we know that we appeared on this earth 200,000 years ago, and we know that we haven't changed, and now that we know that the DNA that makes us who we are appears to be more than a random process of biology, the question now is, what does it mean to have that kind of DNA? What do we do with it? How do we awaken the extraordinary abilities that that DNA, that fusion, gives to us in our lives and gives no other form of life? So I want to thank you for joining me for this program today. And be sure to tune in for our next all-new episode of Missing Links, the deep truth of our origin, history, destiny, and fate.